Joe, and I'm still smitten very much in love with you. But like I said, if I saw you in public, I'm not going to bother you. I'm not going to approach you. You know how to get a hold of me. Somebody did call and hang up recently, so I'm still thinking about calling that number back. It was an unusual, you know, not like the typical robotic calls and that sort of thing, but or text messages. I might, but hey, girl, I'm there for you still, and because you're that good, you're worth waiting for. And if you're playing hard to get, you're doing a good job, because I still like you, love you, and want you very much. And every time I think about you, it brings a smile on my face, and it just makes my heart leap, the thought of, you know, ever being able to hold you someday and, you know, commit myself to you, and that you would commit yourself to me, and we could live a long, healthy life together, happy life. And I plan on living to be 120, so I'm only halfway there now, and I promise to take care of you, and you're going to make it as far as, hey, right there with me, baby. And take care of you, keep you healthy. That's it, man. That's all. I guess that's about all I have to say about that. But man, I know my values. So that's what I have to tell the whole world, is that you know, when they say, "Well, this doesn't relate to me. Why is he talking about this girl he's in love with?" Well, it does, in the sense that, you see, I mean, you know, I wear my values on my sleeve, and that's it. I've spent way too much of my life alone for a guy that values a female, okay? And I'm just putting it out there. I figured it out, man. I know what it's going to take to make me happy. And she is it, okay? And there's only one her. That's a problem I have. Otherwise, I just say, well, I just want a girl just like her. That's what I'm looking for, and start this similarity, that similarity. No, there's something about her. You know, once you get hooked on a certain person, it's like, I don't know. This has never actually happened to me before on this basis. Never. Never anything really close to it. There's just something about her, like an ancient memory, a long-lost love, something weird, man, like a spell. Something really freaky is going on. But if this is the woman God wants me to have, that would explain it. And if I'm the man she wants, that God wants her to have, then that would explain it. And then we will come together one day at a time. I mean, I might be dead tomorrow, or she might be. I mean, you never know what's going to happen, what the future holds. All I know is I cherish up the thoughts I've had about her. My life is better. I had a beautiful dream about her, and I've wrote poetry about her from the heart, and it's just all been beautiful. And to this day, I'm very glad I'm still very much in love with her. I like her a lot. And God, she's just perfect in every way imaginable. I like nothing more than to snuggle this girl, just to hold her in my loving arms, and just make her the happiest woman in the whole world. Give her all those things, what all the women in the world love about their man, love about having a husband, okay? That's what I want to give her. Whatever those things are, those qualities, she's going to get from me, because she can hint, allude to it, and intuitively I'm going to know. She's not going to have to spell it out. She's not going to have to say it. She's not going to have to shout it from the rooftops. I'm going to know what she's going to want, what it's going to take to make her happy. And I'm going to give it to her good, okay? Any way she wants it, baby. That's the life I'm going to give her. I'm going to make her happy. I'm going to give her happiness well and good. Okay, I'm going to start with where I left off last week. And with thoughts that I've had in the last couple of weeks. I'm getting backed up, so it's thoughts from the last 2 or 3 weeks. Yeah, friends, I've had a really good life, and I continue to have a really good life, and it keeps getting better and better and better. And I hang on to the hope. I have an iota of faith and believe the good guy is going to win this thing, so keep up the good work. Fight the good fight, because if you're a good guy and you keep your heart pure and invite the Holy Spirit of truth into your life, you're going to find your way. Ask, seek, and knock, and you will find. You're going to get rewarded. So I want to encourage everybody. But I feel very grateful, and I don't care what people think about my financial situation. Okay, I'm doing great, and I expect to continue to do great, whether I ever find a beloved or not. But I'm living less than half a life, because that's what a woman is to me. It's huge, man. I mean, when I've really figured, I mean, I knew it with my first wife. She was my beloved. She was perfect in every way. I devoted myself 100%, but I screwed up and I lost her and she doesn't want me back. And I cannot live the rest of my life alone. I refuse to. And if God says I don't have to, then I'm not. And I'm hooked on Lauren and I want her. But if she doesn't want me, I don't want her. But I've got to, you know, one day at a time. Again, my life keeps getting better. And don't let anybody tell you that, you know, youth is so great and all. Look, we're all destined to get old. I kid with younger people. I say, whatever you do in life, don't grow old. Yeah, as if we have any choice, right? We don't. And but like wine, you get better and better and better with time. So don't sweat it, man. It just gets better. That's what I'm telling you. You get better. If you're on the right path, your values get better. Everything gets clearer. Your mind gets clearer. You come out of Babylon. You come out of ignorance and confusion. If you're on the right track and you turn to God for your help, it's going to get better and better and better for you too. I promise you. I promise you. And that's biblically based promises. I don't make a lot of promises. I don't make them lightly. But when I'm 100% confident, I do. And when they're backed by God, I can make those promises. But anyhow, imbalance is rarely, if ever, a good thing. Yet we've been trained to accept ever-growing imbalance in our economy. That imbalance in our economy is good. That it is an inevitable consequence of, quote, capitalism. And anyone opposed to capitalism is by default a communist or socialist and un-American. Any person opposed to capitalism and progress relative to capitalism in the form of ever-growing wealth imbalance are as good as American as apple pie, as good and American as apple pie. That you are a traitor, a hater of American values, if you don't wholeheartedly embrace capitalism, that you love capitalism, if you love America. And the irony is, all we've had in America is anti-capitalism since the assassination of JFK. Never underestimate the power of the female, female of the species. Do so to your own demise. Oh yeah, I believe that. While it is true that I cannot afford to be the most generous brother in the world, know this much. If I had my way, you'd have your way, your very own government-approved money printing press apparatus. That's right. For all intents and purposes, quote, capitalism has not existed in any viable true form in at least 56 years since the assassination of JFK. Foundational hallmarks of real capitalism are risk and competition. By creating and issuing a competing currency, as JFK did, he proved to be a true capitalist, giving the Fed a run for their money. As we found out, they didn't find competing currency funny. A long time ago, I figured out that I too can enjoy playing games. And capitalism, both crony and genuine, are both games. While I'm fine with playing a game with rules which apply across the board, I'm definitely not okay with rules that don't. That is to say, rigged games. Rigged games are a turnoff, man. I have absolutely no desire to play the game, even if I win, because in my mind, I would lose. Our relationship with our divine parents, that is the Creator God Almighty, is by necessity a mutual one. Just as we need God to know, love, and understand us, we need to know, love, and understand God. We need that personal relationship, my friends. Well, you know what? I see the next thought is a long-winded one. And so I'm just going to end it here because I see my tape is about over. Listen, I love everyone. I want the best for everybody. I'm enjoying my little life. I want you to enjoy your little life. Keep a pure heart. Ask God for right values. Be a good, decent, upright human being. Wish that others had all those same things you want for yourself and your family. Okay, and you know what? You're going to be found worthy and deserving of inheriting a better realm from here. And that, to me, is what it's all about. And in the meantime, you're doing the best thing you can do. You're fighting the good fight. You're fighting for justice. Okay, even if you've got justice, you feel free and you feel secure, do it for somebody else. Because ultimately, that will please God. And God is the grantor of true happiness. So by pleasing others, by caring about other human beings as if